And agricultural news from AgView.net. A new report finds the Market Facilitation Program created deep regional inequities, favored certain crops over others, and funneled money to large ag operations over smaller farms. Senator Debbie Stabenow, the ranking Democrat on the Senate Ag Committee, said the report is a result of a government accountability investigation. She requested that investigation all the way back in February of this year. Says the administration needs to stop playing favorites and start helping the farms that are hit the hardest. That report found that southern farmers benefited significantly compared to other regions of the U.S., and 8 of the top 9 states with the highest payments per acre were in the south. The report also says that instead of providing more support to the 9,852 largest farms, USDA could have targeted funding to the thousands of small and beginning farmers that are often more vulnerable to market swings. The Mid-America Crop Life Association has honored an academic leader at its recent virtual annual meeting. The award is presented to an individual who has demonstrated significant contributions to American agriculture, especially in the MACA region. Also, the person has to have demonstrated evidence of consistency in educating the public on the value of production agriculture. Dr. Rice, a university distinguished professor, he holds the Vanier University Professorship at Kansas State. He is a professor of soil microbiology in the Department of Agronomy. He is also a past Nobel Peace Prize winner for his work with the UN Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change back in 2007. He, as many of us know, a relentless advocate for conservation agriculture and is one of the most influential speakers in the U.S. on soil health and conservation practices for production ag. Congratulations, Dr. Rice. Well, for the first time in Gallup's 20 years of tracking America's views on various business and industry sectors, farming and agriculture is now the clear leader. The former top-ranking industries, restaurants and computers, remaining still in the top 4, the grocery industry rounding out that group. Now, meanwhile, pharmaceutical industry's image has improved a little bit since last year and has yielded the worst-rated distinction back to the folks in the federal government. This year's rankings reflect significant changes in the ratings of 6 industries, 3 of which are delivering some vital goods and services to America during the pandemic. These 3 include healthcare, farming, and pharmaceuticals. They are all rated more positively than they were in 2019. And the biofuel industry welcoming the Environmental Protection Agency's decision to reject those so-called gap year exemptions from the nation's biofuel laws. In total, the agency received 68 retroactive exemption requests from petroleum refiners seeking to maybe skirt some obligations under the renewable fuel standard, and the move denies the majority of those pending requests. In the announcement, EPA Administrator Andrew Wheeler said this decision follows President Trump's promise to promote domestic biofuel production. Meanwhile, the president also recently announced the executive order to allow E15 to be used in any pump approved for E10. That is the national standard, and that move should allow more expansion in the E15 market. More on these and other stories at AgView.net. Stay with us. More coming up.